The number of oxygen atoms minus 1 gives you the basicity of the acid. There are so many different phosphorus oxy-acids. If you're suddenly asked about their basicity or about their salts, whether they're acid salts or normal salts, do you find it all a bit confusing? So today, I'll teach you a quick and simple method. Just take the number of oxygen atoms, subtract 1, and whatever you get, that's the basicity of the acid. For example, 4 minus 1 equals 3. It's a triprotic acid. 3 minus 1 equals 2, so it's a diprotic acid. 2 minus 1 equals 1, so it's a monoprotic acid. See? That makes it easy, right? Now, this is just a clever trick for figuring it out. But what's the principle behind it? My dears, the most reliable way is to learn how to draw the structure. What we're discussing here are inorganic oxy-acids. The way to determine the basicity is to see how many hydroxyl groups it has. That number is its basicity. Of course, there is an exception. You can type it in the comments if you know which one it is. If you're not sure, you can check my previous videos where I've talked about it. Next, let's take a look at how to draw the structure of phosphoric acid. For any oxy-acid, the first thing we do is put the element that isn't hydrogen or oxygen in the center. In this case, that's our phosphorus. So what's next? We know phosphorus has 5 valence electrons, so it should form 5 bonds. Let's start by placing the oxygen atoms around it. At this point, we'll see we have 4 oxygen atoms, right? If we draw single bonds, that's only 4 bonds, which doesn't satisfy the 5-bond rule. So we change one of the oxygens to a double bond. What about the remaining 3 hydrogens? We place them on the oxygens because oxygen needs to form 2 bonds. And just like that, we've drawn the structure of phosphoric acid. We can see that it has 3 hydroxyl groups. Therefore, it's a triprotic acid. Now let's look at its corresponding salts. If it reacts with sodium hydroxide, consuming 1 mole of it, and we replace one of these hydrogens with a sodium atom, we get NaH2PO4. At this point, the sodium has replaced this hydrogen. There are still 2 hydroxyl groups left, so it can continue to react with a base. Therefore, this is an acid salt. If we remove another hydrogen, that's like replacing 2 of the hydrogens with sodium. There's still 1 hydroxyl group left, so it can still react with more sodium hydroxide. This is also an acid salt. Now, what if we replace this one too? That means all 3 hydrogens have been replaced by sodium. At this point, there are no hydroxyl groups left. It can no longer react with sodium hydroxide. Therefore, this salt is a normal salt.